kikhub or kabati si tv lawan ra shapi da ko umsingam beats aqua na molai moro hakajing dap sans nem jonka rengkat ka three allers restaurant m crown hotel khindaila shillong but ka orange nissan lonso po shillong 118 yakakali datsan very go batmai kabas kem bat bit door
ki nongtrei jong ka meghalaya energy corporation limited हाक नो फाइसंगी जोंग खाथन रेतरिक उनो परा आरजार आरफो किलापन कुन नो यका जिंगिखी बलापन लोंग दक जिंगशा थंगन दक जिंग यदि शालंग बट उ चीफ मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर जोंग के एमईईसीएल उ अरुण कुमार केम्भावी हदिन बकी बोर पन्याय किलापन बना बा अनसिउ नो यका तुलप बासा तेंग जोंग उबनाय रिसाव आरजार आरफो हाक खाथन रेतरिक उनो परा आरजार आरफो हाक जिंगिकरन बट कबातिसी टीवी उ प्रेसिडेंट गकिनहोन जोंग किनोंगत्रे के एमईईसीएल उबा पीके छुलन उलियाथो हदेन बकी बोर पन्याय जोंग के एमईईसीएल किलाखोन या किनोंगयलम शकमी जिंग यक्रेन लपनतिम बा यकतुलप जोंग उबनाय नाइवेंग बट जोंग उबनाय नोप्रा रंकत बट का बोनस अन सप्लाई नो हकतयो कबनसवान शुशु लयाथो रु बकी बोर पन्याय जोंग के एमईईसीएल किनससेउ नो मनला उबनाय कुंबजुलोंग यकतुलप जोंग किनोंगत्रे
We have met the management. Subsequent to his call, he has called us through a written letter. We met him. We have had a very comprehensive and meaningful discussion with him. And we are happy to say that he has agreed to look into our issues, all problems that we have raised. Not only for the welfare of the employees of MECL, but also for the welfare of the state in general. Prominent among the issues that he has agreed upon is to release the pay of October by today.
Yes. Hey! Long live Kormo!
Long live
Kormo!
Long live!
And he had also agreed to release the pay for November within this week.
Next week.
And also, he has agreed to release our salary from the coming month within the first week of the month.
Yes.
And he had also, in fact, offered saying that if possible, he will give some advance for Christmas. So this is an immediate measure that he will be taking. And at the same time, there also, as we know, there are some action, perhaps it will require some thinking and some strategy. So he has, you know, said that it will be categorized into a long term and short term. So for short term, let's say for loans, for our terminal benefit, he will pursue it with the government, because as we know, the terminal benefit has been denied to us since 2010. He is very much aware of this, and he is also not happy that the terminal benefit has not been extended to us. In fact, in other states, when corporatization process was rolled out in 2010, 11 and 12, all the states have extended the kind of benefits that was required to be done to the employees. However, in our state, our Meghalaya government have not done at all. So he said he'll pursue this vehemently pursue it with the government, so that our terminal benefit also can be released. At the same time, he has also given an assurance that henceforth, free hand will be given to our officers to take a call on the defaulters.
Yeah, that's a good news.
If any company's check bounce, free hand will be given to the officers to file an FIR against that company. He had also said that soon he will issue a blanket order for disconnection of the defaulters, giving a free hand to the officers. And in terms of this unnecessary loan, he said he is doing some assessment, and this will be also within a short term scheme wherein he will look into this. And most prominently, this smart meter program also will be scrapped. Yeah! And in respect of other loans, like the loan that they have availed for construction of lines and substation, wherein there are some unnecessary works, unnecessary components in the loans for drip. This also, he said, he will look into and he will take necessary action. And as far as privatization is concerned, he said the day before yesterday, he had said no to REC PDCL, and the answer will always be no for privatization. So as we came out today, we must say we have extended our gratitude to him for understanding our problems, and we appreciated his willingness to address our problems within such a short time, where we perhaps we do not have to carry on with our agitation anymore.
We would like to add some more here. First of all, we would like to thank all the employees. Yes. Three cheers for employees of MECL! Yeah. Three cheers! Yeah. Three cheers for employees of MECL!
Hooray. Hooray.
We have been united. We extend our gratitude and thanks to all the employees. Because of the unity, we could achieve this. No one would like us who are here to come out in the street in this manner. But we have been compelled. Good sense prevail. As employees, we take our pledge to extend full support to the government, to the management, and we assured that each one of us, be it at the lowest level or the top level, will work with sincerity to see that this organization prosper. As I have said, we are one big family, where we had a discussion regarding the regularization of our contractual employees. There are employees, contractual employees, who have been working for the last 20 years, 15 years. There is no more future, there is no more hope for them. So we have requested our CMD to relook on this, because already there is a minute of discussion which has been initiated by the management for their regularization. So we do hope that the aspiration of the contractual will be fulfilled. And also, we would request our Honorable Chief Minister, his cabinet colleagues, to please give a serious thoughts on terminal benefits. We are overburdened by all these loans because of the default by the state government to pay us this terminal benefit. As you are aware, the actual valuation as of today is not less than 2,000 crores. The Honorable Deputy Chief Minister today has given a statement, which I would just like to say, sir, you were very much there on the 9th September 9 empowered meeting where between the empowered committee of the state government constituted by the then state government and us as unions and associations, where it has been statutorily stated that the benefits of the employees in the new utility shall not be less by the then deputy chief minister. So these are all the records which are available with us, and we would please request to please relook into this and request the state cabinet to please call for an urgent cabinet meeting specifically to discuss on how to avail loan for the terminal benefits of the employees.
I would like to give my sincere thanks to all of you for being together with us. We are not talking just about our own immediate needs. We're not talking only about our immediate requirements of salaries. We had been talking with management about a long-term recovery plan for the corporation, because this corporation is one that provides an essential service, something that is present in everybody's lives. Without electricity, no one can survive nowadays. It is essential. What I want to say to the public is this: we have never wanted to inconvenience you. We were forced to come up to this level of agitation because our needs were not met. In the future, we would like to say that we want to promise our full service to the public and to the citizens of Meghalaya. When you have your complaints, please do come. We will try to resolve. We will try to do our best. And at this moment, I would like to say that since the management has agreed, and since they have said that they will give it in writing about these various demands that we have put forth, hence, as of this moment now, our agitation stands suspended. So we are calling an end to our agitation as of now.
We have our CMD with us here. Like I have said, after the meaningful discussion that we had with him, in front of him now, I am declaring that from this moment, our agitation is suspended.
I have been, pleading before all our employees and association unions not to resort for any strike, because the management is working around the clock to ensure that all our employees get the salaries timely. So irrespective of whether you had resorted to the strike today or yesterday or not, by end of the day today you would have got the salaries. So as we speak, the salary bills are getting ready for the month of October, and November also, within a couple of days we'll release the salary. So to the best of my abilities, we will also try to clear at least half of the salary of December, so that it is treated as a Christmas bonus or something. But again, I feel bad that we had to see such sad scenes which could have been avoided. I've already taken moral responsibility for not releasing the salaries timely to all the employees, which is on record. In spite of that, my commitment to you is going forward, I'm sure the fund cash inflows to the corporation will jump exponentially starting from next financial year with all the reforms that we have been taking together. So my firm hope is that all the employees of the corporation will stand with the associations and the corporation in solidarity, so that we don't have to see such scenes in future. And going forward, I hope that very soon the distribution company, or the DISCOM or MECL as a holding company, will go into a positive fund flows trajectory. So we have discussed so many issues, all the issues in the memoranda, and my commitment to you is that we have split all the demands in the memorandum into short-term, mid-term and long-term solutions. So short-term, the salaries and stuff, the mid-term, and the long term, the terminal benefits and everything. We have chalked out solutions for each and every demand of yours. So I'm just asking for some kind of cooperation from all the association, so that I've seen so many today the first time I'm seeing so many familiar faces together. So my fervent hope that you will call off the agitation. In fact, I offered the tea to your office bearers in our office itself, but they refused, saying that they will rather have they'll rather break the fast with the fellow employees, not in the office room. So I have, in fact, all our staffs and officers in the corporate office are also fasting along with you, but it's a silent protest. So I'm also fasting since morning. So I would like to I thank everyone for bringing all these issues, pending issues, which have been lingering for last 10 years, to the attention of the state government and the management of the corporation. Only thing I want to say is that we believe that unless the staffs are paid, officers are paid, we can't expect them to perform. So it goes without saying. And also, I've already committed to the association that within next week itself, we're going to release the O&M expenses also, the POL, the vehicle hiring charges, and so many other things. And our material management also has become extremely active now. And I'm sure all the divisions have received their supplies. My hope is that this year, the corporation will ensure uninterrupted round-the-clock electricity supplies to all the 30 lakh population in Meghalaya. So this is not my single resolve, my resoluteness. It is the resolve of every single employee of the corporation. So we should aim for colorful and full of lights Christmas this year and the new year.